Setting the camera up. Hi everyone. Good afternoon, good afternoon. It is Thursday, the 17th of October, and we are just at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. England time. Hi Lindsay, hi. I can actually see the messages. This is fantastic. Once again, I can see the messages. Hope everybody's doing well today. I'm once again plan not to be on here for too long, but afternoon Angie, but you never know, we can get carried away with stuff. I want to give everyone an update on having my meters changed legally and lawfully. And the conversation that I had with the engineer and the conversation that I've had with another anonymous person, and confirming what you are actually paying for with your utilities. So we're going to discuss that. And we're also going to discuss certain people in the movement that are now starting to attack me, which I've never come across before, never spoken to before. And yeah, so clearly I'm upsetting a few people with the process I'm doing. So we're going to discuss all this. Let me put them back. In the meantime, while I wait for a few of you to come on, I gather you can all hear me, you can all see me, you can all... You've got your drinks, you've got yourselves comfortable, and you're with me for about an hour. Hi, Danny, how are you? Hope all is well. I'm sure the weather where you are is much better than the weather we've got here. In fact, last night, how many of you saw the lightning storm and the thunder? Literally laying in bed, curtains open, and it was like a pink show. I'm sure it was an electrical lightning and thunderous. Yeah, it just came from nowhere. But then most of these things do, don't they? Right. I'm going to start. What I would ask, and I will ask this at the end as well, is, and I'm not asking you this because I'm trying to gain recognition or views or likes. I'm asking you this so that other people can do this if they so wish to. They've had a lot of questions. How do I do this? How are you doing this? Blah, blah, blah. Please share this live. And anyone that hasn't been following me or is new to me, go back. I've done a live a couple of days back from this one. If you go onto my channel, it's there. I will also probably upload it onto YouTube. And the reason that I'm asking if you guys can share it in groups. If you want to share it on your Facebook, write a little status first. I don't know. Anything, Laura Nina updating on meter installation, and then link in comment box. The reason that you need to do that is I'm seriously shadow banned. And if you write a little status, you know, so that the color doesn't change, and say link in comment box, that bypasses shadow banning to a degree. I'm trying to reach out to as many people as possible. This is probably the wrong time of day to do the live. I should have really waited until about sort of, 5-6 o'clock when more people are at home, and spoken about it then. I will be talking about the Richard Vobes podcast. I've actually got it. It was sent to me, not the podcast, although the podcast has been sent to me, but the transcript has been sent. We're going to read that. We're going to talk about it. We're going to talk about a number of things. So please share it. Empower people, because I genuinely believe we're onto the right thing. And again, I reiterate, anyone that is telling you, any of these groups on Telegram, anyone that's supporting these groups on Telegrams, anyone that's interviewing someone that's telling you just remove your meters and they're charging you $250, $300, $500 to have the meters fitted, run. You don't need to do that. You literally do not need to do that. They are conning you. They are scamming you. They are not helping you, and in fact, they're putting you in a worse position in the long run. And now, why would they be putting you in a worse position? What I've learned is in the last month or two since my meters have been, since I got broken into and I got meters replaced, I've learned that you're not going to run away from this. And the only way to beat the system is to pressure the system. It's to fight the system. And I don't mean fight with fists, but I mean fight with a pen mightier than a sword. And so the only way you are going to achieve anything is to apply your mind to what your heart desires. And my heart desires justice. My heart desires fairness. My heart desires that we could all live, you know, in a world where we can all afford to have the necessities in life. That's what my heart desires. And that's including myself. And I want it for everybody. What I want for me, I want for you. And that's it. Everything I want for me, I want for you. And that's why I'm doing this. And I'm doing this free of charge, which is why a lot of people are getting upset with me at the moment. And we're going to name those people. I'm doing this for the love of my children, your children. I just want to learn and I want to share. I've got some people that are saying to me, you're doing this wrong. We're going to discuss that. And if I am doing this wrong and you've got a better way of doing it, please share it. That's all I can say. As you guys know, I had my meters. I didn't tell you that what day I was going to have them. I didn't want to say too much on my previous live. So there's been a lot of questions that have come back from that live that I'm now going to answer and change, because I didn't want to say too much in case I cause myself problems. And I'm going to share these. The engineer turned up 2 days ago. And he phoned me and he said to me, oh, I'm because the appointment was, he came earlier than the appointment time. And he said, are you a business, you know, are you some kind of yard or something? I said, no, I'm a private home. And he went, oh, okay, that's fine. So he turned up and we had a nice chat. Again, I can't give names or anything. I'm not here to get this engineer into trouble, but we had a really good chat. I'm going to read to you some of the things that the engineer expressed. Again, I don't know if he's right, I don't know if he's wrong, but either way, it's interesting. And we can work, there might be a little piece of the puzzle that he might have told us that we can fit to something else, to part of our journey, you know? He found out that I was having my meters taken out and he said, oh, you know, no problem. I had no problem. I thought I was going to have problems, but actually no problems at all. He believes, I'm going to read from here. He believes that if you own or have your own meters, you don't need to pay a standing charge. Now, I don't believe that to be true. And we're going to talk about charges. I asked him if he could cut my gas off first because I was running my washing machine, and he said, I'm afraid I can't, because they all work, every bit of work they do is regulated and controlled by an app. Now you might think, why am I saying this? But I'm just pointing out what humanity, what mankind has become. They are robots to an app. And they cannot move around unless they do exactly what the app said. So he had to cut my electric off first because the app would not allow him to do the gas first. Everything is regulated. People have become robots to technology. And it's going to get worse. He informed me that prepayment meters, which is what I had, a prepayment meter, are fading out. They're getting hard to find and they are no longer really being fitted. I'll read questions and everything at the end. So the prepayments, they want to do away with them. This is why they are starting to fade out. I asked him how many private meters has he fitted. And in the 10 years that he's done this, he's never come across a private household meter removal. He said maybe one, but he doesn't even remember it. He said it just does not happen, and I'm quoting what he said. In his words, no one changes their meters, which is strange because you're allowed to do it and they can't do anything to stop you. There's no way around it. You're allowed to change them. So this is from an engineer that, by the way, works with a company called SMS. Right, I'm just making notes because there's a comment that was sent to me that I'm going to have to mention. So meter. I'm just making notes to remind myself. So he's been doing this 10 years and he knows that you are within your rights to have your own meters installed. This is from an engineer that's been doing this for 10 years for a company called SMS. Hi, Murray. I did reply to you in your inbox. He believes the stand in charge may not only be for the meter, but also for the supply of electric and gas to your property, which I'm going to talk about this because I've recently learned something else, literally just before I started this live. They buy the gas electric for a silly amount and they sell it to you for massive profit. In his words, it's all a scam. Share this live. I'm pleading with you. I wouldn't normally. Please share this live because what I'd like is more people to empower themselves, more people to learn their rights. But also, if there are any engineers or anyone working for the utility companies that would like to contact me, you can remain anonymous. But what we need to do is expose this huge corruption, because they are, it's such a big scam. It's a huge scam. It's fraud. How did you start the process about removing the meters? Interaction from billing. So I wrote to them and said I would like to have my own meters installed, and they tried to tell me that I can't because I explained this again in the last live. I can't because apparently the meter comes hand in hand with the supplier. So I challenged them further. I said it's my right enshrined in legislation, in the Gas Act and the Electricity Act. I'm allowed to own my own meters. And if you do not allow me to have my own meters, you are going against my constitutional rights and so on. So it was a bit of back and forth. And if we don't all join forces and do this, right, then they're just going to take over. You know, people are saying we need to do something. Well, we are doing something and we all need to do it in mass. It's going to get harder. They're going to challenge you, but you have the right to install your own meters. So the gentleman said to me, smart meters do not work. If I make a mistake, it's because I typed up notes wrong, so bear with me. I can't be perfect all the time, you know. Smart meters do not work in the benefit of the customer. He has an old meter. He won't have a normal meter, a smart meter. He said they have been fitting digital meters since 1970, but it's the signal which causes the problem. If it does not pick up the signal, it won't connect to the network. And if it's a weekend and it drops out, it will cause all sorts of problems. These smart meters have little pins on top of them and a 2G SIM card which dials out, but if it does not pick up the network, it won't go into prepayment mode. We know that they are trying to push everybody onto smart. Smart is not smart, so try to avoid the smart meter. And maybe at the end of this live, it will make more sense why. So who do we pay? Bear with me. Who do we pay? We're going to talk about the payment at the end. So with the old meters, you get more for your money because they are not accurate. So smart meters are super, super sensitive and they're actually charging you more, whereas the old meters are not quite as accurate. So you get more for your money. So that's another reason why this man said he will not have a smart meter. By the way, he's on £50,000 a year. So it's not a bad job, is it? He doesn't do any guesswork. The only thing he does is install meters and deal with meters. That is it. It's a good business for now, anyway. The worst part of the smart meter is they collect real-time information. Everything goes to the government. The government get all of your readings. Your provider then logs on to your account through the government site, and they all get their real-time data. Now, I cannot confirm if this is accurate. All I can tell you is what I've been informed by someone that's been working within this industry. However, we know that our data is the commodity. It's the value to these people. So your the real-time data. So the money is in the data. They will know how much they are buying before they can stop the wastage when buying off the network. So the data will relay the information. So they will purchase a certain amount from the network, and then make millions on that amount, but they don't want to purchase too much. So that's why these smart meters are really, really important, because they can get your data instantly. So this is how they will make millions for their investors. He said in 20 years' time, this is his belief. I don't know again how. No, energy is not owned by the government of Ireland, so it's already been funded by a taxi. I can take anyone through. This would be great if you can do that. I do believe that, yes, it is funded by the taxes, but they're still making money. And the reason I believe behind this is because the grid has been partly privatized. And I can't remember where this message is. It's there somewhere. I'll have to find it. But although the grid gets a funding, they have actually partly privatized, and it for American company. They joined onto an American company. So anyone that's really good at looking at companies, I applaud you. Do some research, come back to us. I'm going to name some companies. It's not my strength, but I'm learning. Like everyone out there, I'm learning. He believes that in 20 years' time, round about 20 times, you'll have no real meter engineers. You'll just have people going around doing breakdown for emergency for the electric and gas. Same on the network, and whoever owns it at the time, which he believes will be the Arabs, because they are buying everything. Now, this is key. Now, this is why I'm urging everybody to do what as much as they can, especially the people that have been faced with the same dilemma as me, where they broke into your house, or they're challenging you, or you know they're going to enter. Try and do it in the right way. Install your own meters, because the one thing we do not want is these big time investors to take over. So he believes it will be the Arabs, because they're buying everything and they'll be making a fortune. So say that right now they've got 10,000 meter fitters. They will probably just have 500 in, 10, 20 years, going around just doing breakdown. So this means that if your meter breaks down, there will be a shortage of fitters for emergency work, and you'll have to wait days, even a week, until someone gets to you. Knowing this, that means they are pushing for something else, because they need to. So it'd probably be for the smart meters. This is where it gets interesting. Anyone that's really, really good at company searches, one of the meter companies that he works for, the meter company he works for, is called SMS. This is just meters, okay? They have just been bought out for 1.5 billion by a company called KKR. I have got this here, bear with me, and I'll give you the full name. KKR, I've just gone onto their website, is an investment company investing in people, companies, and communities. They are Kohlberg, Kravis, Roberts and Co. This is honestly, they are making a killing while we are struggling. KKR have just bought SMS for 1.5 billion. KKR are a private investment company firm worth 500 billion. This is what this gentleman told me. They go around buying companies up for a billion or two, strip them out, reduce anything they can, and then between 5 to 7 years, they flog them on at 20% profit. SMS are still SMS, even though they've been bought out by KKR, but they are worth 500 million. But they will still remain under the same name of SMS, even though they've been bought out by KKR. If you go to KKR's website and you look at their investors, there is a massive, let's have a look, massive, let's see if I can go back, portfolio of people. Here it is. I mean, you have got about 10 pages. Anyone that wants to look at this, 10 pages of different investors that they have bought out, and it can be medical, utilities, the companies can be 123 dentistry, Agas, which is industrial, go through financials. So they literally buy these companies out. They're not going to buy a company if they can't make money on it. So this constant flow of corporations making investments and making money. They are worth billions. What we done, so there we go. So SMS, even though they, you know, that's what they do. So there's profit, because there's so much profit to be made in these companies. That's why they want to invest in them. In this, in conversation, when we were talking to him, it was described that if a builder was to do some work in your house, but you didn't pay him, he can't just break into your house and remove his work, can he? He would absolutely get done for this. So why is it that these utility companies can do that? The more, this is, you know, this isn't right. If someone, if you've had any building work done, or if you've had some paint and decorating, or you've had something done to your house, and then, you know, maybe you've had problems with the builder, and then he's like, you know, I want the money, he's got to take you to court. How are these companies getting away by breaking into your house and taking, you know, and forcing you into poverty? And again, that comes down to the fact that they have their own meters in your house. So they have a part ownership of something, even though they don't actually own it, but they own, they pay for your meter. They have a contract with the meter, and they've put the meter in your house. So it kind of gives them, even though it's wrong, and I know it's wrong, but it kind of gives them a right of entry. That's how they're getting away with it. And that's how they bypass, by putting their meters. But there's another reason why they want their meters in your house. So how they bypass this is by getting a court order to allow entry to your home to stick prepayment meters in, because they have to limit the debt. This is what he said, because they are responsible for buying off the grid. So they don't want your debt going into a lot of money, because they still have to pay the grid, even though they overcharge you. But they have to make sure that they limit the debt. So that's why they go to these administrative fake courts and come up with fake warrants and break into your house, because they are responsible for buying off the grid. So their argument is, rather than spending 10 million that they don't need to, they have a legal entitlement not to buy the 10 million off the grid. Otherwise, they're minus 10 million every year. So they have to take the steps to make sure people are on a prepayment. And that's why they want all these, meters put in. Everything comes from the same place, gas, electric, it all comes from the grid. But they have set up a system. This is, again, this is a conversation with the meter installer. They've set up a system. The system has been set up like a pyramid scheme where all utility companies go, right, that million cubic litres, we'll own 10%, you'll own 5%, you'll own 50% and so on. And then it gets divided between the customers. And that is capitalism. Is it moral? Is what they are doing moral? I'm going to go on to the Richard Vobes. It's been sent to me, so I'm going to read this out to see if this relates to any of you. Again, I know Richard has done it. He's taken it from a group called Stop Paying Billing Companies UK. I'm going to read it out here because some people may not watch Richard. So the more we can spread this message, the better. Someone wrote a letter and it says, I remember when Maggie Thatcher privatised the utilities and wondering how British Gas, with no infrastructure in the electricity generation and supply industry, could suddenly, overnight, supply people with electricity. And this is a really, really good question that we can actually ask the utility companies. Where do you store the electric? Where do you store it? If you are buying a certain amount of gas or electric to then sell on, where are you storing it? If they're not, it's because they are not the supplier. They're just a broker. Or how the previously electric boards became companies that could manage to supply gas in direct competition with said mighty British Gas. How could someone create a new company, make no investment in the infrastructure, enter the market, and then supply gas and electric? It's called drop shipping. That's interesting. Thank you. Why aren't more and more people asking these questions? Why? I mean, that's probably a silly question for me to put out in the first place, because we had, sadly, we have order followers. We have minions. We have people that just that are not interested, they just want to get on, pay for what they, you know, can afford. But if, like me and many others, you're starting to have enough, these are the questions we should be asking, and more. You know, how can they have gone overnight without putting any infrastructure in place to then owning and selling it back to you? So then when changing suppliers, how seamlessly the physical changeover happened. No switching drops as my electricity came from a different company. No drop or falter in the gas pressure at the changeover time. What technological marvel had the devil woman and her cronies conjured up to enable this miracle? It's all profit. It's all they are profiting at our ignorance. That's what they're doing. These questions and others remained unanswered. And in the back of my mind, as I got on with the daily grind of being a good little sheeple and not questioning authority, in the last year or two, the unanswered questions surfaced, resurfaced with the help of other people via the internet. So, again, this is not my writing. I started researching, asking questions, reading online documents until the scales fell from my eyes. There is no technological marvel, only a good old-fashioned scam. We are being so scammed right now. Statement of fact, number one. The supply licensee companies that we, the consumer, pay our money to, supposedly for the supply of gas and electricity, do not supply the gas and electricity we have consumed. That is a fact. They can't supply it because they cannot store it. just a little example. When you go into a shop, normally a corner shop, I don't know why they're called corner shops, but you know what I mean. Old-fashioned corner shop, newspaper shop. They sometimes you buy a can or something, yeah, like a can of Coke, yeah, and it says on there the price is, you know, they sold as a six pack, so you cannot sell it as an individual. So, you know, there's things like that to stop consumers abusing their powers. And, you know, they buy in bulk. They buy all their goods, they pay for their goods, and then they sell them on to you for a profit. And these shops have to stock all this. So, where is the gas and electric provider that's selling you this storing it? Statement of fact number two. The supply licensee companies issue a statement of account, not a bill for gas or electric. Wording is magic. Statement fact number three. The supply licensee companies are suppliers, not of gas or electric, but of credit. The scam. When Maggie Thatcher granted licenses to the various companies that generate, distribute electricity or supply, distribute gas, those licenses did not allow said companies to offer extended terms of credit. You need to maybe listen to this again. What I can do, actually, at the end of this life, I will copy and paste this to the heading. So if you want to read this for yourself, please do. Those companies must be paid for the gas, electricity that they have provided, distributed at the end of each business day. So at the end of every day, the companies still have to pay for everything. To knock on every consumer's door and demand payment for the day's consumption is both physically and technologically impossible, which is where smart meters come in, because they can give real-time data, so they know how much utility that they're going to pay for. Data is the commodity. So that opens the door for a whole host of parasite companies known as the supply licensees. When these companies buy a license from the government, they purchase the right to pay on behalf of, but not totally unknown to, any supply address they can convince to sign up with them. At the moment, there's a deemed contract. There's like a deemed contract. So, who is your supplier? So, if you look at your address, there's a deemed agreement, but they're not actual contracts. They, in fact, purchase the liability of that supply address to pay the generators, distributors, the actual true cost of the gas or electric at the end of each business day, based on meter readings, actual and estimate. Now, this is where I'm going to carry on reading this, but actually I'll come back to that and do it all at the end. I don't want to get too confused. As they have provided unsecured credit for that supply address, they then add their own charges for this credit to the actual true cost of the consumed energy and issue a statement of account. As everybody should know, unsecured credit is a very costly item. This means the consumer of the gas electric at the supply address is paying for the actual true cost of the consumer energy plus a credit agreement they didn't know they had and never agreed to. So we are paying for the actual true cost of the utility, but we are paying something that an agreement. We are paying for an agreement between the provider and the supplier that has nothing to do with us. 100%, it's secondary false fiat stock market, false credit monopoly. Yeah. The situation is both unlawful and illegal on so many levels. If you want to make a difference, start doing it. A, It's illegal and unlawful by falsely posing as the supplier of the consumed energy to the supply address. The supply licensees are in breach of the Fraud Act 2006, Section 2, fraud by false representation. They are not your supplier. Your supplier is the grid. They're the ones that are supplying through the pipework to your house. B, by not disclosing that the consumer is agreeing to a credit agreement, the supply licensees are in breach of the Fraud Act 2006, Section 3, which is fraud by failing to disclose information. C, by not disclosing that the consumer is agreeing to a credit agreement and will pay their credit charges, as well as the actual true cost of the consumed energy, the supply licensees are in breach of the Fraud Act 2006, Section 4, fraud by abuse of position. And I think this is really, really important, guys, because we can use this, especially when you've got your own meters. And even if you can't put your own meters in, you can still use this. The supply licensee companies that we, the consumer, pay our money to, supposedly for the supply of gas and electric, do not supply the gas and electric we have consumed. One, the supply company issue a statement of account, not a bill for gas or electric. Two, the supply licensee companies are suppliers not of gas or electric, but of credit. The scam. When Maggie T granted licenses to the various companies that generate. Did I read this already? Because I hope I haven't double backed myself. No, I have. That's it. That's where I am. So I've done this. So that's opened the door for a whole load of fraud. So we've got Fraud Act 2006, Section 2, Section 3, Section 4. There may be more breaches to the legislation. What about the unfair terms in Consumer Contracts Regulations 1999, the Consumer Credit Act 2006, the Consumer Credit Act 1974, and the list goes on, as well as the basic common law of you or your actions shall cause no harm or loss to another. And this is what is happening. Them and their actions is causing harm, loss and injury when you think about the little old ladies or the people that just cannot afford it. But I mention the old because they are more vulnerable, sitting in their homes freezing because they can't, you know, they have to choose between heat or eat. That is causing serious harm. I would add also a moral code in this. You know, what is this moral? I mean, if we think about our basic human compass, yeah, making unreasonable demands. Thank you, Alice. It's not moral, this, is it? I mean, if we're talking about that we are, you know, we're here to make a difference and we're here for justice, and we, most of us, want to be able to just, you know, go to work, live our lives and whatever, but they're imposing so much debt, you know, onto us and putting us in severe hardship, depriving us, and so on and so forth. It's awful. So the supply licensees can then turn these fraudulent obtained credit agreements into negotiable securities and receive payments for them on the money markets. By the way, a lot of the MPs, which is why I say to you guys, do not look for idols, because the people you think that are there for you, like the MPs or even that one MP that's fighting your corner, trust me, none of them are there for you, because behind your back, while they're telling you this, they are lining their pockets, and they're lining their pockets with things like this. They are the investors, the shareholders, They're the ones that are making money on you. So while you think they're there to help you and to restore democracy and to make Britain great again, they're actually siphoning from you. So the recent PPI scandal involving mis-selling by the bank pales into insignificance by comparison of what these people are doing. Every household in the UK has been affected by this scam. What can you do about it, you may ask? This gentleman, whoever, I don't know if it's a man, sorry, whoever wrote this has said, well, I am reminded of a campaign fronted by Nancy Reagan when she was America's First Lady against drug use. The campaign slogan was just say no. Because the supply licensees did not disclose they were offering credit, there can be no credit agreement between themselves and the consumer. Without a credit agreement, no consumer has any liability to pay any charges. The supply licensees cannot ask a court to enforce an agreement that does not exist and never did. Ask your supply licensee for a copy of the credit agreement that exists between the two parties and they will not be able to produce one. On the other hand, the contracts that exist between generators and distributors, etc., and the supply licensees companies, so OVO and the grid, are perfectly legal and binding. They have accepted liability for the cost of the energy supplied by the supply address and they must pay them. Challenge them. He says, just say no. Now, I would not do that. You know, I think we've been placed in a position of disadvantage here. You know, they've got all these shareholders, stakeholders, third party interlopers, you know, all these people are, they're trading them. They're trading, they're trading your data, and making money for the shareholders. And we are being placed at a disadvantage because we're being treated less favorably than others. And they are profiting on our hardship, which they've caused in the first place. Again, we have to go back to the basic common law principle of you or your actions shall cause no harm or loss to another. And all this is a harm and loss to us. You know, we are being harassed into feeling that we have to do what they say, intimidated, coerced, I would even say blackmailed. Because if you don't do what they say, they're going to cut you off or they're going to send the big boys round and so on. So the reality here is, who is actually really stealing? Is it us or is it them? I know who I think is the real thief here. So now I go on to another piece of information that I received today. I've got my own meters in. I will read some messages of people that have asked questions as to why did you put your own meters in. And let's just go and get them. I'm going from A to B to C to all over the place. Ofgem and Ofcom are also supported by these corporations, just like false emergency services. Absolutely. Right, let me go back a second and make sure I do this right. So right now, my meters have been changed. Again, there was letters back and forth. There was one question here by someone that's been told by their provider that if they want to have their meters removed, then it would cost them something like 150 something pounds per meter to have them removed. I would suggest that you write back to your company, whoever that is, to the provider, and say that it is your right to have your own meters fitted. And if they do not come and remove their meters, then you will charge them for storage because they have their property in your private home. So therefore, your private geographical location is where they are keeping their property without your consent. So therefore, if they think they're going to charge you to have those meters removed, then you will just charge them storage. Also, you can, you've just got to keep doing that. Are you on prepayment, by the way? And if you do it in writing, then you've got evidence. And if they insist, then report them to Ofgem, because it is your right to have your meters installed, and it shouldn't cost. Because did it cost you? Did they charge you to have those meters put in? Did you? No, they didn't. So why am I doing this process? A lot of people have said, why are you doing this? What is the benefit? How can you fight someone when your hands are tied behind your back? For instance, I had prepayment meters in. I can't go against the prepayment meter. I have to top it up. I have to pay their tariffs. Otherwise, I get nothing. So my hands are tied behind my back. Now I have my meters in. My hands are loose. I can breathe. I know no one's going to cut me off to a degree. Okay. So that was the first step. It's how can you win the game if you don't know how to play it? And what I'm learning on this journey is people want to make that final winning move without learning how to play the game. And we can't get to the finish line without taking part in the game. And this is all this is a game. And the only way we're going to win is by all of us learning to play the game. Now, I'm no one. I'm not legally trained. I don't have legal qualifications. I have probably spent the last 4 years wasting more time on the wrong people, the wrong groups, the wrong things, when I could have spent 4 years studying law and legal and legislation and constitution, but I haven't. But what I did was apply my mind in a week, look at different legislations, look at people that I can rely on, and done this. And somehow I've miraculously had my meters removed. So this is why we need to do it, because we need to play them at their own game. And the more of us play the game, and the more of us corner them into a checkmate position, the more of us put the pressure on these companies, the more we win. What if we set up a company and go direct to the grid ourselves? You can, but you have to get investors. So I'm doing this because it's legal, it's lawful, and it puts pressure on them where they don't like it. Now, I'm sure that they're going to change the goalposts, but until we do, we need to keep doing this. We can't expect to win overnight. There's going to be things that I'm going to be faced with, that I'm going to come across, that I'll probably go, oh my God, what do I do now? But it's all a learning, isn't it? It's all learning to play the game and play them at their own game and actually beat them, because we can. Where did you get the meters from? I got mine on Amazon and eBay, and they're all registered. They're all got a number on. So in my previous life, I said that I was going to register my meters with them and give them meter readings. Since then, things have transpired. And so now I have given them meter readings. However, I'm going to move about with that a bit, and I'll tell you why. But as for the NMAN numbers, I'm going to challenge that, because I don't wish to register my meter unless they can provide me with the legislation, the enactment within the legislation, the law that says I must register the meters with them. What they'll say is, if you don't register the meter, then it can be classed as theft. However, theft is only if you refuse to pay. I'm not refusing to pay. I'm willing to pay. And therefore, they can't do me for theft. And I've got every evidence. I will print everything off. As long as you can evidence it, there is nothing they can do. So I'm going to say, that's fine. You know, on a second opinion or something like that, I don't know, I'll word it at the time. It will come to me when I'm in my, you know, state of flow. I'm happy to give you the meter numbers for registration, as long as you can provide me with the legislation or the law, the enactment within the legislation, which says I must. Now, it's like when they told me that I had to give them the name to the meter fitter and the number, their company. Well, again, show me that legislation. Allegedly, it's on Ofgem's. Well, guess what? I'm not employed by Ofgem, so therefore it doesn't apply to me. We need to remember that legislation only really applies to business, a place of work, a business, a corporation. And if you are employed by such corporation, then it applies to you because you signed a contract to be part of that corporation. So therefore you have to follow. Now there's a moral code everywhere. So, you know, there's law, but this legislation does not apply to me. So what I've then found by someone that I spoke to just before the live is very similar to what we've been talking about. If you look at, this is very quick, I probably won't give it the justice that was given, but I'm not very good with numbers, but you can understand. You've got your own meters in, you've managed to get them put in. Then you're going to say, you're not going to register the meter numbers, but you do not want to fall in the bracket of having them at your door and trying to do you for theft because you're not paying. So what you want to do is make a contribution that will get them off your back and that will be financially feasible for you. As long as you are paying something, then you are not refusing to pay. And that is the most important thing here. Do not refuse to pay. Pay something. I was explained that if we take, for instance, 100 Green Energy, their cheapest tariff is 34.5p per day. That's the standing charge. So if you look at Northern Energy, the dearest is 72.10 per day. That's the standing charge. When you buy your electric with whoever, or gas, the standing charge you are charged could be half of what they pay per day. So if we've got 34.5p at the cheapest, the likelihood is they're probably getting it for 20p or less. However, they are not paying 34.5p, but the utility companies still have to pay a standing charge to the grid. They're buying it very, very cheap and they're selling it to you. So they are making money on the standing charge anyway. You know, if whatever they're charging you, they're making money. OVO are charging for gas 31.73 pence per day standing charge. And for electric, 47.39. Now, I guarantee you that's probably the half of that is what they're paying. The rest is profit. The rest is profit. They are making profit on that. The other thing that they are making a lot of money on is the rates that they charge, which is the unit price that they do not pay the grid, and that is where the profit margin comes in. Let's have a look. Standing charge, unit price. So the unit price I've got here is 6.90p per kilowatts. That unit price varies. So that's my gas. And the electric is 27.55p per kilowatt. That's with OVO. That is what the investors get. There is the profit. That is where they are making billions. So you are being, so they're buying it off the grid. Whatever the unit price, the standing charge is, you probably they're about paying half. So they're paying the grid, but then everything else is the profit. Everything. And what they do is they say, oh, join, I don't know who they are. We've got energy, British Gas, whatever, because they're all trying to sell you a cheaper standing charge and a cheaper unit price. But that is what they are making the money on. And that they are making, I think, I don't remember how we worked it out because, again, I'm no good at money, but one company was making 18 million just on unit prices. And that's where the shareholders are making a fortune. So now, when you've got your own meter, you don't need to pay that unit price. You're private. You don't need to pay for the meter. But it's recommended to get them off your back that maybe you pay the your standing charge. So the standing charge, I don't know if you want to pay £30 a month, which will get them straight off your back because you are making a contribution, you are covering their costs, and they can't come for you. And you can set up, if you want, a standing order that you pay them each month. And therefore, rather than paying, I met a lady yesterday who's paying £200 a month for her gas and electric. Rather than paying that, you're paying £60 a month for your gas and electric. Which one sounds better? Now, I'm not here to tell you to not pay. That's not what this is about. Just like it's not about that with me. What I'm here to do is to get everybody to fight for their rights and destroy the shareholders, the stakeholders, the third party interlopers, whoever is trying to make money on you. That's what I'm here to do. I'm not telling you not to pay. I'm not going to say I'm not going to pay. But no, you see the kilowatts, Stephen, the kilowatts per rates, that's what the utilities make. That's not what the grid charges you. That's where they make their profit. The standing charge is what the utility companies have to pay. That's the service agreement between the utility companies and the supply licensees is the standing charge. Everything else is the scam. So you agree the standing charge or to pay a, if it costs them 30, 50p a day and you're happy to pay 60p a day or 70p a day, you've covered that standing charge. It's got to be reasonable, it's got to be fair. A kilowatt from the grid is like 0.08p. Yeah. This is something that we need to do. We need to get these freedom of information requests. We need to challenge them, but we must remain in honour and pay. So if it's £15 a month, pay. If you're reaching hardship, but as long as you pay, because then they can't say that you are stealing it. Because when you own your own meter and you're doing it properly, they will try and bring in the Theft Act. And that is when they will try and dig up your road. So that's where I'm at the moment. I've got to, Trevor, can you message me at the end what it is you want me to mention, please? because all these messages are going too quick. So yeah, I did watch Vobes's, and this is what we spoke about as well. They have an agreement with the grid. It's the suppliers that have got an agreement. They're buying it. Sadly, we can't contract directly with the grid, but we don't need to. It's all a scam. But what you don't want is to fall into the theft act. That's what you don't want. I hope that makes sense. Have I got any questions? Please. So I do the freedom of information request, find out. They don't want to tell you how much they buy it from the grid. They don't. But as long as you're paying, they can't come and do you for anything. Right, so I'm going to answer some questions now that were put forward, and I'm going to address something. Axe and statues went in the bin in 2013. They cannot stand on any axe and statues. Absolutely. Some of the questions that I had, what is the advantage of owning your own meters if you are still paying the provider? I don't get it. Right, so hopefully I've explained the advantages. No one can come into your house ever again. You need to have safety certificates. That's fine. How did you find a name of the man that installed your own meters? It's a friend. So who is qualified? Someone qualified has to do it. I've got, you know, you do your gas safety certificates. I keep mentioning that OVO are buying electric off the grid. They do pay the grid, which is where the standing charge is, but they overcharge you on the standing charge. So let's have a look at this message. Reason I asked this question is because each year the government thrashes out a deal with the grid for the country's needs in electric. Yeah, you're right, they do. The grid gets funded by the council, the government, sorry, with our taxpayers' money to run the grid. Someone was telling me that the grid has also been privatised, and I think this is where they're making more money. And look, we're all here to brainstorm together. If you know something that can help us, that we can challenge these with, then let's do it. We have to do it. We're playing the game. We need to get our pawns on the board in the correct way. We need to make the right moves. And the move that you make must always make you remain in honour. That you are willing, but you are not going to be deprived. You are not going to be taken the piss out of. And that's where it is. They don't own the water. Anglian Water told you they own the water. Excellent. So I'm still paying standing charge, yes, but it's going to be at my rate, not their rate. So you don't tell them that, obviously, when you want to put your meters in, and you will have a fight. Some of you may have more of a fight than I did. You have to use the legislation. You have to use the constitution. You have to use your human rights. Use whatever you can to push them in the corner. Threaten them with whatever you can. Wasting your time. Threaten them that you will charge them for, you know, storage. Report them to Ofgem. Threaten them to report them to Ofgem if they are depriving you of your right. Etc. etc. So that's why there's an advantage to having your own meters, because ownership has been removed. Therefore, they cannot jump into your ship, which is your home. And that is what you want to take away. I've said this before. I still stand by it. I believe a lot of those groups out there on Telegram, on wherever, even on that Richard Vobes show, that woman telling you we can change your meters, they are putting you in the worst position. You have the power and the energy within you to do this properly. And if you do it and just hide, then you're not learning. So then I've got another question that I wanted to address. What I found very, very strange, actually I'll come back to that, because there's someone that commented, and I'll come back to that. Let's have a look. Are you saying that the meter should be changed with their consent and register them with them afterwards? I did say that initially you do have to change the meters, not so much their consent, but you have to get their agreement. You have to get the agreement in writing so that there is no comeback from that, and they have to agree it. They have no choice. And initially I said register with them, but now my meters are fitted, I'm going to rethink that. And I'm going to challenge the registering the meters with them. There's also the fact that if your town has incinerators, I've missed out, I'll have to come back to that. So they have right to remove your meters because the act of taking out theirs and fitting yours. So this is when they will, if you follow any of the advice from these groups and you get your own meters fitted in, I personally can't help but wonder if it was a massive data breach, data collection, so that, you know, the utility companies can now go and swipe all the properties because they've got all your names and addresses. I don't know. The conspiracy mind comes in and they can come and fit smart meters. So if you do it properly, no one can enter your home. So, you know, if you changed your meters and didn't tell them, and didn't get them to take their meters out, is classed as tampering. And that's when they can apply for health and safety and fake warrants to enter your house because you've tampered with their property, even though their property shouldn't be in your house in the first place. However, if you had been paying, you can't just stop. You have to get them to remove it. So that is the tampering, you're removing. Right, so how does it work when they need to replace pipework? The pipework has got nothing to do with your meters, okay? The pipework belongs to the grid. It doesn't belong to the utilities. All the utilities own is the meter. If you had a gas leak or an emergency electrical fault, the gas would be the gas Caden, whoever the grid is, that come out. It's not your provider, it's your supplier. So that's how another scam that they are doing. They're selling you something that they can't even come to your house in a case of emergency. If you get a gas leak, Ovo don't come to my house. They call, or you know, you report it to the gas emergency works, Caden. So no, you don't need to worry about the pipework because the pipework is taken care of from the grid. National Grid deal with the actual supply. A different company, Morrison Data, where I live, will deal with meter issues. So that's how it is. There's two different companies here. So these are some of the questions that I'm dealing with. Right, let's have a look. So now this is, let's have a look. If you put your own meters in, you will have ownership over them. Do you necessarily need your own meters to do this? Right, that's a good question. It's all about meter ownership. So you've got a choice. You can leave the ownership to them, where it gives them power over entry into your home. Or you can remove that ownership and give yourself power so that they can't come into your home. The one thing you do need to do is have certificates for safety, annual checks, especially with the gas. Mine's been done. Let's have a look. I've got a few. Last year I wrote to the Eon CEO and he promised not to fit a smart meter. We have a box outside. Yeah, they don't need to fit smart meters. You know, this is where it goes. Right, let's have a look. I've got here a long one, I think. If you don't remove your own meters, that is tampering. If you don't remove your own meters, that is tampering. And where others fall down, you get your provider. So you don't remove your own meters. You've paid in your taxes. What about many who do not give a rat's ass about taxes and don't want nor ever will work they've not paid anything in taxes. Actually, people on benefits do pay taxes. So even people that are on benefits, you actually pay taxes still. You do pay a standing charge to whoever now puts gas to your property, and it is not National Grid. Yeah, it is. The standing charge is paid by the utilities to National Grid. It's not National Grid that their standing charge is really, really, really low. NG organise its distribution nationwide, and the providers are responsible for getting it to your property in law. No, they're not. The providers are not responsible for getting gas and electric to your property. That's the grid's responsibility. Hence, when you change providers, new ones continue, because if there's a problem, they come to fix it. No, they don't. The providers do not come and fix any gas or electrical problem unless it's to do with the meter. So I'm not sure if that's what you meant. The standing charge has got nothing to do with anything other than what they pay the grid. Are you covered by National Grid if anything goes wrong with a private meter? You know, I believe there is a company that does come and look at your meters, by the way, and it's free. I'll have to find out. You do pay a standing charge to whoever now puts gas to your property, and it is not National. Yes, sorry, I've read that. You can get your own meters, but you are obliged to get them checked annually. It's best for health and safety. And an authorized and certified safety engineer installs them. Not sure about that, because you do want someone to know what they're doing. Yes, you do, because you are messing about with electric and gas. So you have to know what you're doing. The only advantage of your own meters is you are certain the readings you supply are accurate, because you know your meters are calibrated annually. That is not the advantage. The advantage is that you literally only need to pay the standing charge each month to the grid, so that you are paying something, or you pay what you can afford. Have I got any questions? I used to pay 29 a year to supply energy to your property. Yep, we used to pay exactly. It was on the National Grid website 2 years ago. Right, Trevor, let's have a look. Right, I need to mention something here. Trevor Melam, can you please mention my case? Support wanted, please, next Friday. Just called court. Hearing to now be at 10:30, Friday, the 25th October. That's my birthday. Rolls Building, Fetter Lane, London, EC 4A1 in whatever. Now, Judge David Halpin KC, can you explain to me what your case is about? If anyone wants to go and support Trevor Melam, I gather that's in London on the Friday, the 25th of October at 10:30 a.m. Please do so. Trevor, can you let me know what the case is for so that I can let people know? Another advantage of having your own meters, they can't coerce you to take a smart meter. Absolutely, there's lots of advantages. I'm going to read another message, and then I'm going to get on to something that I find very interesting. Good morning. Thank you for your email regarding meter ownership. Oh, this must be a copy of someone's email they got back. Your energy supplier may or may not own your meter. However, they are responsible for the asset. Energy meters are typically owned by a third party, which is true. Meter asset provider to whom your appointed supplier pays rental for the meter. This is true. Right, so Trevor's case is fraud and human rights abuse about bait and switch with Lloyds Bank. It's my birthday, Trevor. Am I going to come and spend my birthday with you in court? I don't know. I'll have to think about that, because I think I might not be here. So meters. In some cases, energy supply. So basically, meters are not owned by the energy company, the alleged energy company. Like I said, SMS is the ones that owns the meters. OVO get the meters fitted by SMS. So in some cases, energy suppliers may own a portfolio of meters. The appointed supplier is responsible for the management and maintenance of your meter via an appointed meter equipment manager. Am I 40? I wish. I'm 50 to next week. As a consumer, you are entitled to own your own meters, which must be certified and fit for purpose. Right, where it says certified and fit for purpose, most meters are. So they get reconditioned. They have to meet the national safety standards. They get a sticker on there. So as long as you buy a meter from a reliable source, most of them that are selling meters are certified. They must be installed by a certified meter equipment manager. That's not true. At your supplier's request. That's not true, because you are in the private. You are not employed by Ofgem. We need to understand this, and you need to really understand this. You are not employed by Ofgem. So therefore, you are not employed by OVO or any electrical company. You are not working. So you can use whoever you want, as long as they are qualified in doing so, and then get certificates therefore. It cannot be installed by a qualified electrician unless they are an accredited ME. No, that's not true, because you are in the private. So I understand what this gentleman's saying, but I think, or gentleman, or I don't know who this is, you use who you want to fit your meters. You are a private home. It's your private right, your human right to live in the private. As I said before, you don't need to let your landlord know that you're what paint and decorator you're using. When you have a gas cooker fitted, you don't need to let them know who's fitting it, or an electric cooker. You just do what you do in your private home. As long as they're all health and safety to standard. So how come on another group it's £400 a meter? Because they're scamming people. You can buy meters, electric meters, brand new for 40 quid. You can buy reconditioned, which are just as, you know, they're reconditioned, but they still have a 10-year sticker. A gas meter for £60, £55, and get someone, you know. So you will, so you still give meter readings. Right, now this is where it gets interesting, because if I'm now going to be challenging them, I will not pay the profit. So we're going to use some of the stuff that's been put on this live, you know, some of the legislation, and we're going to challenge them, and we're going to say, you know, actually, under the Fraud Act, you are committing this, that and the other. However, I'd like to remain in honour, and I'm willing to pay the standing charge to the grid who supply the gas and electric, and I'm willing to pay £15 a month standing charge. Up to you, isn't it? If there's a dispute and you want to say, and they come back and say something to you, and they say, we're not happy with £15, then you can negotiate £20. That's the whole point of owning your meter. That's the next battle. Customers owned energy meter standing charge will still apply, along with consumption charges. No. However, I would expect the standing charge to exclude the cost of the meter rentals. No, because the cost of the meter, I don't even know. Let's think about it. A meter is brand new, maybe, it depends, £150, £200. I mean, spread that over 10 years. They've got a 10-year warranty. So for 10 years, SMS has responsibility over these meters. How much standing charge is that going to cost you? So again, some of the comments you have to be very careful of, because there's a lot of fear tactic here. Someone's commented and said to me, Laura, I'm afraid you're still doing it wrong. Apologies, you're doing it way you think is best. I don't get bills. Have you countered of any of their emails, letters with Companies Acts, Bill of Rights? I pay nothing. It's all paid for by the government. So this is a a message, it was a comment on my Facebook by Just There Browsing 11. Just There Browsing 11, you really need to read the Companies Act, like I keep on telling people. Your bills are contracted to governments. Sick of telling people, the case goes to stages. I stopped correspondence when I got to stage two, as they have no grounds. All you need to do is make a yearly donation. You still need to make a donation, if you wish. I won't be explaining anymore as people aren't listening. We're all listening now. All you have done now is agreed to contract with the companies. Bad move. You are in contract until you move. You are in contract. You're in contract until you remove your own meters again, as they have serial numbers now. Right, I'm not giving them the serial number. So again, I said that initially. I have a right to change my mind upon further investigation. You have to be careful what you put in writing, because you don't want to scare the other side and say, I'm not paying you, I'm not doing this. Upon further investigation, I now need the legislation or law which requires me to give them whatever. When they give me the legislation, it has to be for me in the private, not for me employed by a business, as they have serial numbers now, which they so don't need. A meter is just to say how much energy you use, nothing more, but you can negotiate, but so can all others. Exactly. Right. I completely agree with you, Just There Browsing 11, completely agree with you. And if there's anything else that you can recommend that we can all work together, because this is not just for me, this is for everyone. I think it's great what you're doing. So if there's anything else, please do come forward. So you can negotiate. Go to compare.com and other platform. Let us negotiate. You have to get your supply capped, cut off. There for any contact are cancelled between yourselves. It costs about 105, which you did. After that lays the issue, then the Companies Act kicks in. So interesting. So we can look at the Companies Act. Let's have a look. This is very good. You hit them with the legislation. They fill you with lots on meaningless drivel at first. I waited till I got to stage two. Then I just ended all correspondence. I've never had a bill since. I think with OVO, as I'm with them, done all mine in about 4 years back or so. And you can't get done for theft, as government pays them. If you're worried about it like me, you can offer a monthly payment. But like this lady said, you have to make a payment, a yearly payment. So if you want to do it monthly, even if it's £10 a month, you're still paying. Most bills are in fact estimated, not smart meter ones. So companies give those estimates to get paid from governments. Absolutely, which is what we spoke about. That's it. Thank you for that. Now, this is the interesting part. I have a good friend who works for the National Grid, and he is going to try and find out how much all these credit brokers. Thank you. Let me know. Please keep in touch. Listen, we are here to share. Until I get taken down, I'm sharing my journey. If you can advise me more, like this lady, absolutely, or whoever it is, I don't know. I don't want to misgender you. Just share, and we share, and we empower people, which is why I ask, please share this live. I'm asking again, it's not for likes or whatever, it's so other people can empower themselves and do the same thing legally and lawfully. Get your meters changed. As I said, I was going to register my meter with them. I am now reconsidered that I want the legislation, or the law, sorry, which says I must register. We know what must means. What was interesting is some of these comments coming up next that I'm going to read out to you. I have never, ever had any interaction at all with this woman. I have never had any comments on my Facebook before with this woman. It just, as I'm speaking to you and I'm warning you, and I have warned you before, against these groups that are making a killing putting meters in, they're not even giving you a safety certificate, and they're actually putting you in a predicament where they're not going to be there to help you when these criminals come and install, break into your house and install their own meters. They're putting you in a position of weakness and not power, because you are once again, like I did, I own up, giving your power to someone else and praying that you can hide under the blanket and go unnoticed. And you may go unnoticed for 2, 3, 4, 5 years, but trust me, they are coming for us all. So, a comment was here. What is the advantage of owning your own meters if you're still paying the provider? I don't get it. A response was made to this comment by a Stacy World Rocks. Now, who knows Stacy's World Rocks? She said, none. This information is misguided. Okay, that's fine. So I replied to Stacy. Hi, Stacy. Can you clarify for this thread which information is misguided? Funny thing is, I've been blocked. Now, I thought we were all on this truth and movement together and we're trying to support each other. And some people know less than others, some people know more than others. But, you know, some of us genuine people don't give a shit about money and we want to do the right thing for ourselves as well as everybody else. We're sharing our experience, and guess what? We're not charging anything for this. And I thought this is what it was about, but it turns out Stacy's World Rocks, doesn't feel the same. She feels it's important to comment on my wall. Yes, I've heard many, many, many bad things. I had a load of replies. She was a troll. She's not a troll. I tell you, this is so. I replied, I got blocked. But what she did do is advertise Stacy's World Rocks on my thread, on my post from, I think, when I said that the meter removal man, you can have a look there. The meter removal man came and removed the meters and he said that I was the first one in. Have a look there. She decided to advertise a David Keane, Dan's Meters Telegram group. Dan the Meter Man. So these are the guys who supply and fit are legit. They are qualified and Corgi register. And here is my meters. If you don't already have Telegram, download. So they're selling you exactly what I'm talking about. Seems Stacy supports this. She says, someone said, next one to deal with is the water. Let's share some information. Absolutely agree. Let's share some information, guys, especially everyone that's been doing this for years. Stacy's World Rocks says, stop paying that in 2020. And then she gives her link to her Telegram. That was really helpful. How did you stop paying? No, she just blocks me. Okay. There are people that don't want you to know the process because these people are making a lot of money on your ignorance. And she said, this person believes legal system has power. Bless. I'm not sure if this person is me. Who knows? But what I do know is we are dealing with absolute criminals. And I don't want to put people in shit, especially vulnerable people that might want to do this. So they tell you, this Dan's Meters tells you, you close your account with them. Most people say they've moved out. Okay, that's not going to work. So you're going to pay him probably, what, $250, $300, $400, who knows? You're going to tell your provider... And that you've moved out, you've become the occupier, you've put your own meter in. How long do you think that's going to last? I'll tell you, it lasted about 2 years for me. So be careful. Remortgages with Stacy has had to help one of her followers recently. Wasn't she asking for help against mortgage? I'm sure there was a call out to her property. So my question is, Really, where are you helping, Stacey, by blocking me, putting irrelevant comments on my Facebook? I asked you, can you clarify, but you block me because clearly you don't want to. Is it because I'm treading on your toes and depriving you of making money by scamming people? Let's have a look at Stacey's prices. So she does consultations. So she goes around the country. Listen, I could quite easily do this. I'm telling you now, I could quite easily go around the country. I could set up a really great presentation, selling you all sorts of rubbish. Whether it's true or not, I don't know. I don't care. I can tell you to remove your meters. Don't tell anyone. This is what you need to do. I could do all of that. I could travel around the country, meet loads of wonderful people, get paid for doing so. I could do that. I don't want to because that's scamming. I'm not a scammer. I'm not regurgitating other people's work. I'm trying to learn my own and share it with you. Let's have a look. She's got in-person talks in Chelmsford on the 21st of November. If you guys want to go ahead and see her, I wouldn't waste your money. 6:30 till 9 p.m., £25 per person. £25. I mean, they're telling you, obviously, no one can afford to pay at the moment. I mean, the prices of everything, I seriously, I'm struggling like everybody else. Sorry, I'm struggling each month. You think I'm going to go and pay £25 to go and listen to an arrogant, obnoxious, condescending, I don't even want to carry on because I'm not going to go into that. To talk about crap. Does she claim to get payments refunded for people? Oh, probably. There's another one in London on the 24th. Again, £25 per person. You can go to Manchester. It's cheaper in Manchester because the people are not as well off. £15 per person. Or she does Zoom calls. 30 minutes for £40 or 1 hour for £75 video calls. So, I'm now beginning to understand why Stacey might have felt, after all these years of never speaking to me, to comment and tell people that I'm wrong and that I'm stupid for being in legislations. So thousands of us have stopped paying altogether. I will never pay them a bean. Well, that's good for you, love, because people like you, I've learned in this movement, and I know many, many of them, they talk the talk, but behind the scenes, they don't walk the walk. They do the opposite. Don't trust you. Very disappointed that you commented on my status to do with meters and you didn't even have the decency to share honest information and support. If you felt I'm doing something wrong, why didn't you discuss it with me? I'm actually quite a really, really approachable woman. I'm not going to bite your head off. I like women that empower other women to do the right thing. Seems you're not that woman. So this brings me to exactly my point. Be careful what you do and who you go with, because there are so many scammers out there. And it seems that I've trod on toes for the fact that I have never had any interaction for this by this woman before. Now I'm hitting on meters and finding some little solution so that people don't get screwed over, so that people use law and legislation, so that people can feel comfortable because there are people that want to be able to pay for a service. And, they believe actually I'm using this, I want to do the right thing and I want to pay. And I'm saying to you, do you know what? Pay. Act in honour. Don't act as a thief, even though we know they're the ones stealing from us. If you know how to work the system and you can get away with it, and we're going to try what this lady said, the Companies Act, let's see what we can do. Let's see how much pressure. But the reality is, it's not about not paying. Just because you are called a truther, or you see yourself as a truther, or you see yourself a higher moral grounds than everybody else, does not mean that your shit don't stink. We have to pay in life for things. It's just the way it is, but it has to be fair. It has to be honest. Everything right now is a scam, and this is what we need to uncover. but we are not going to uncover the scam unless we put our pawns in the right position and make the right moves. Making the right moves is thinking about, right, I'll do this and then I'm going to study so that I can find out what my next move is. And that's what I'm doing. And I'm sharing my journey with you, and it's costing nothing. All I ask is please share this live in groups, do a little status so that it bypasses shadow banning and put it in the comment box so that other people, if they want to do this, they can. Because everything I've done is in law, is in law. And yes, they will try and come for you. But as long as you keep playing that game, rebutting their letters, going back with questions, freedom of information requests, and you can find a way to checkmate them, then they're not going to win. You win. Laura, it's time to come out and share information on these people to bring them from the dark to the light. These people are scammers. I cannot believe. I mean, I've heard stories about Stacey. I'm not even going to go there. I'm not interested. I'm not here to, talk about her as a person, but her behavior, what she done. Could you post both lives you did on Tube when you get a chance? I'll put this one up on YouTube and then, yeah, I will do. See if there's anything else. Having the knowledge of how the game is played is of great benefit. And you have... Oh, thank you. I'm still learning. I love learning. And there's all different ways of doing things. But again, I change your meters. 1K discounted. Yeah. Honestly, it's finding genuine people. There are genuine people in this movement, but it's very, very hard to find them. And when I say genuine, I'm talking people that are not driven by greed, ego, violence, revenge, you know, money, all of that. Genuine, because they genuinely want a better way of life for everybody. And if we're not careful, and if we don't start doing this, and if we don't start challenging them, they're going to keep growing bigger. We have the right in law. Everything is there. You know, everything. As that engineer said, we have the right to install our own meters. They just don't want us to know that. Because the moment you put your meter in, you take away their ownership. You take away their power. What you also take away is their unit rate. You don't need to pay for that. You actually don't need to pay for that, because that's not coming from the grid, right? The standing charge, they're charging you. This is for my gas. Oh, look at this. Right, standing charge, 31 days at 31.73 pence a day, works out £9.84. That's for the gas. As I said, an example, £9.84 at 31.73 pence a day, guaranteed they are paying half of that. But even if you say, fine, I'll pay for the standing charge that you pay to the grid, that's not even £10 a month. Laura, what did the engineer say about it? Or was he independent? He was hired. He's an independent, but he was hired to do this. If you go back to the beginning of the live, I read out everything he said. Yeah, so that's for the gas. Let's have a look at Ovo's monthly standing charge. Look at this. So 12 days and 19 days added together, they've worked it out at £15.98. Now, I'm not sure why they separated 12 days, one at 47 pence and one at 54 pence, the 19 days. But again, you don't need to actually pay any more than the standing charge. Thank you, Lauren. Lauren Robinson, she's got some great stuff on her Facebook. So if you guys want to go and follow her, she's absolutely great. And do you know what? I should get a little crown. next to me and put the crown on every time I'm empowering another woman, because for me it is all about empowering people, not putting people down. Unless you are trash and you are scamming people, then I will have to out your ass. And you know what, Stacey's World rocks. I've been told how vile you are with people, how aggressive and abusive. In fact, I've been told she meditates, which is far from the truth, because anyone who meditates, you are trying to channel yourself into a very calm state of being. So therefore, you are not a true spiritual person, man or woman, if you are that angry with people. We're here to help and support each other. We're here to try and bring a better tomorrow for our future, for our children, our grandchildren, whoever. If we don't do something about these corrupt companies, I have no idea what my next move is, but I'll tell you what I do know. I'm going to put my head down, I'm going to start learning, and I'm going to start challenging, because it don't matter how much it or how long, there is no way I'm going to bow down to these criminals for them to extort money from us. Again, let's go, let me just reiterate, if anyone wants to understand, the Fraud Act, all this, all the extra charges, right, apart from the standing charge, and even then they're overcharging you, is all under Fraud Act. Fraud Act Section 2, 2006, Section 2, 3 and 4. Fraud by false representation, failing to disclose information, fraud by abuse of position. Was it the Companies House Act that the lady mentioned? There are more breaches of legislation. Unfair terms in consumer contracts regulations 1999. The Consumer Credit Act 2006. Consumer Credit Act 1974. The list goes on. Again, basic common law. You or your actions shall cause no harm or loss to another. When legislation is causing you harm, loss, injury, then it has to be removed. Because we, the people, we, the men and women of this world, have the power. We have the power, not legislation, not corporations, not governments. We as individuals, we will not tap into that power if we do not start learning, applying our mind, putting our energy down on paper, writing it down and telling them exactly where to go. Go and bloody stick it. And the strength here is not how much you get knocked down, like, what's his name, Rocky Balboa. It is in how much you can come back and keep learning and fighting it and giving it back to them. And it is a long fight and it's not going to end, because we are living through some very dark times. But if we don't do something about it now, in this now time, in this now moment, tomorrow our children and our grandchildren are going to suffer. Why? Because you couldn't apply your mind to a piece of paper, start asking the right questions, because you hid under a blanket, done nothing about it, or you paid someone else to do your work and it's backfired. The only way it's going to happen is you and you alone. Not paying these Stacey's World absolutely rocks, who, wasn't she on Virgin? Who's the Virgin man? You know, Virgin Airlines. Wasn't she on an island with him or something? Wasn't she for... Something stinks about that woman, for sure. Even if it's just her character, her energy is really not good. Why not support instead of attack? We're all doing great stuff. Why not support? If you think I'm doing something wrong, explain it to me. Let me learn. If you know more than me, and you clearly think you do, why not, you know, share with me? Am I, what am I to you? Am I a sheeple that hasn't been around and knows as much as you? Well, then aren't you meant to be the wise one and teach the sheeple and try and educate them like we all did during COVID? We went out there, tried to warn everyone. Some listened, some wanted to learn, some didn't. But we still try to help. That's what this is all about. We need to apply. That's it. That's all I've got to say. Apply your mind. Do everything you can. None of us need to be geniuses. All we've got to do is have the desire in our hearts to want to make a change. Work with people that you can trust. So I've got one. I've been fighting the council for 7 years. I did my research and now I'm winning big time. Question everything and make records of it. Thank you. Take printouts. If someone comes to your door and you haven't got the evidence, like, I'm going to print everything out that I've done. If someone comes to my door, I've got the evidence. I say, look, I've got correspondence. I've been allowed. I've been willing. I've offered payment. It's not theft. It's not theft. In fact, if anything, they are the ones that are stealing from us. So, but you still want to remain in honour. Theft, definition of theft. Basic definition is dishonesty appropriates property belonging to another with the intention of permanently depriving the other of it. Is that not what the utilities companies have done? They have dishonestly, because they didn't need to jump on this, we were getting the electric and the gas from the grid, quite happy to pay the grid. No, Maggie Thatcher privatised everything. So a dishonest move right there, because it deprives us. They appropriated property not belonging to them, but belonging to the people, belonging to another, it belonged to us, our taxpayers, we fund it, with the intention of permanently depriving the other of it. And that's exactly what they're doing. They are permanently depriving us because we cannot afford to pay this. Unless you are a couple and you're both earning good money, become a meter operator, a meter fitter, 50 grand a year. I couldn't believe it. Just to fit meters. Wow. No wonder they don't take bribes. They've got a good job. So there you go. And through this theft, right, that they dishonestly appropriated property belonging to another with the intention of permanently depriving us, not only did they do that, but they are entering your home and breaking into your home because they've got their meters in your home. Or you tampered with the meter because you listened to people like Stacey's World Rocks and her mate, whoever the meter people are, and put your meters in without getting them to remove theirs. Do it the right way, and then it won't backfire as much as it will do if you do it the wrong way. Whatever move you make, pay attention. Before you make that move, think about it. Do your research, read some bits and pieces, and then decide, right, I'm going to make this move. I've read this, I've got this right. Because it won't go to court. They don't go to court. Unless it will go to court if you don't do anything about it. And that's what you need to cover. Right, I hope this live has helped. I will update you all if anything else happens, which I'm sure it will. I believe that they even come under extortion. Yeah, this includes extortion, which is when someone seeks to obtain property, money or other assets through coercion or blackmail. Blackmail is an offence under Section 21 of the Theft Act 1968. And given what is at stake, we understand that these cases require very careful handling. Now, I believe that's what it is, because they are extorting money from us through coercion. I mean, you're being coerced in putting their meters in, when actually you can have your own. You tell me if that's not coercion, if they're not blackmailing you. Like when I said to her, I want to put my own meters in. And she said, no, you can't, because the meters come hand in hand with the supplier. Well, excuse me, that's not true. So, and what they then say to you is, we can fit a smart meter in. So you're now lying to me and coercing me into having something I don't need. Think about it. Fraud abbreviated. Party A deceives Party B for Party A's gain. Party B's loss for the intended permanent loss of property. Bricks and mortar, chattels, money. Yep, excellent. You tend to need to apply. No, it's gone. Oh, it keeps jumping. You tend to need to apply mens rea, and it's gone again. Keep going. The extortion and conspiring to commit fraud, and they're all in on it. Absolutely. So, again, I think we've had a massive win. I consider it a win when I'm being informed that in 10 years of this man's job, I'm the only one that he's come across that has had her meters fitted. And therefore, that says a lot. What I would like is, within a month from now, all of you that are sitting on a fence, all of you that are having, thinking, what do I do? I want to hear your stories that you have now had your meters fitted so that you can too be part of the change and bring these corporations back to where they belong, bankrupt, because they're making money on our ignorance. And if we keep being ignorant and allowing them to do so, they're going to grow bigger and bigger and bigger, like a tumor, like a cancer. They're going to spread. So in a month, I expect messages to the point where I probably can't even open all of them. That's what I'd like to see. You contacting me to say, guess what? I've got my meters installed. Guess, even if you're having problems and you're having challenges and you want to talk about it, say, look, I'm trying. But I'm doing this. There's ways that we can do things. We can challenge it. It's your right in law. It's your right enshrined in the Gas and Electricity Acts. It's your right in Constitution. No one should force anything on you in your private life, in your private home. Do you pay for your TV license? Do I? Heck no. Why would I pay for something I don't even watch? Pedo TV, no way. I could not sit there and watch a live TV, any channels on live TV. No, it absolutely infuriates me. I can't. As soon as I see it, I'm like, whoa, no, can't do it. Especially adverts. As soon as adverts comes on, I want to smash the TV, because I can tell straight away it's all bullshit, baffles brains, and people are falling for it. So yeah. I've stopped paying for that 4 years ago. Can't do it. So I don't pay for that. And I wouldn't watch the pedo box. That's right. Yeah. And you know what? It would be amazing if all of you stopped paying for it. Stop paying for it. I want to go back to a message that I found very interesting. So what did the lady, great message. And I think, you know, like, listen, if someone has a go at me or decides to come across sometimes a bit, maybe abrupt, it's okay. I don't care. As long as you're telling me the right thing, I'll allow your abruptness. I'll even, you know, I'm got quite thick skin. So, but have a look at the company's contract with the company. So where is it? We need to look at, because as long as I'm learning, and the only one I couldn't stomach was, this is going to be funny actually, Baron Ward with his affidavits, right? Has anyone actually spoken to him when he was alive? May you rest in peace. I did. Believe me, it wasn't nice. I have never had abuse from a man like I did with him. Oh my God, the things he called me. The names, the language. I was just shocked. That was 4 years ago. All I did was send him a link. He didn't like the link. And he just outright abused me. I couldn't believe it. It's like, whoa. That I can't tolerate. We don't need that. We really don't. So there's legislation, Companies Act, right? That's what we need to look at. I'm going to look at the Companies Act. I'm writing this down. There we go. Have I got any, what about milkman who pays him? I mean, that's a service. You're getting a service you want, isn't it? Right. I spoke to Baron Ward and he called me monkey boy. That's nice. That's actually a nice word. He called me a lot worse than that, especially talking to a woman. I was like, whoa. Yeah, not nice at all. I was actually shocked, especially when people are meant to be so intelligent. And, you know, and then I think, God, you know, the way you talk to people, it's just disgusting. For all that brain and all that whatever, it was like a trigger. Maybe just got so fed up of people just waking up. But everybody's on their learning journey, you know. It doesn't matter when someone woke up. We're all coming together. The pieces of the puzzle are coming together. And this is, we need to be patient. We need to be teachers. We need to be the wise ones. We need to let things go. We need to let people go. You know, not everyone's going to agree. Not everyone's going to want the same thing. We're all different. And if people don't want to listen to you, let it go. You know, let it go. That's a song about that. Oh, he really abused me, Dawn. Honestly, he really abused me. He called me all the names under the sun. I'd have to go back and find it. Baron Ward and the Spaniard, same old. Oh, honestly, absolutely same sort of trash, if you like. He had no patience, having been probably been beaten down, still, you don't talk to people like that. How can you claim to write such an amazing legal document? How can you claim to have all that impressive knowledge and write an affidavit that is meant to be so bloody amazing, yet you can't be polite and speak to people in the right manner? I find that hard. I find that really, really hard. What happened with the cash advising trust fella? Are you talking about Simon Spaniard? I have no idea. I've not heard anything. I don't know if he's tried to contact me. I've had nothing come through my post. I have no idea. No idea. Yeah. Do you know, though, he has been absolutely vile, right? He has actually contacted people's work, even though I'd done a live, and he left a review on Trustpilot on this woman's work site just because she said something which he didn't approve of and he didn't like. He has done this to someone else, contacted their work and told the work that he was being anti-Semitic and whatever. And this is what you're dealing with. Yeah. So it's pathetic. And this is what I'm saying you're dealing with. Be careful of the truther movement. Mark my words. And remember this. First of all, don't follow any idols, because no one's going to save you. You know, no one is going to save you. Only you can save yourself. Secondly, a lot of people in the truther movement do not walk the walk. They'll tell you what to do behind closed doors. They're doing something else. Be careful. Right, I'm going to end here. If anyone's got any quick questions, drop them. Otherwise, I'm going to go. Otherwise, I could just carry on talking forever. some have high IQ, but lower EQ. Yeah, absolutely. That's it. Okay. I'll keep you updated on any other progress. Please share this live. Let other people become empowered. Let other people learn the process. Let other people know that they can own their own meters, and let other people know that they don't need to pay for the unit rate, because that is what's making billions, okay? Because we need more and more people challenging these criminals. Much love to you all. Have a fabulous afternoon, and I will see you again very soon. Mwah, mwah, ciao. I can't log it. Someone's just come up slow connection. Once again, much love to you all. Mwah! Ciao.